What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to be going over how to install and use the EvenMoreFish Minecraft plugin. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. There are obviously quite a few features that Minecraft offers to players, from combat to exploration. But if you're not fighting zombies or discovering new biomes, there are other activities to enjoy, including fishing. This is a great way to obtain enchanted books, food, and more helpful resources, but that's about it. Now, let me introduce you to the EvenMoreFish add-on, which completely changes how you're going to fish in-game. This allows players to get custom items, have fishing competitions, and even earn money from selling their loot. Let's go over how to get started. Head to EvenMoreFish on Spigot and then click the Download Now button near the top right. Save this file somewhere easily accessible for us to use in just a minute, and then do this exact same thing for Vault and Placeholder API because they're going to be plugin dependencies. Head towards your Apex server panel and stop the server, and make sure you're running a plugin compatible version like Paper or Spigot. From here, you can click FTP file access near the top left, and then find and enter the plugins directory, and click upload in the top left corner. On the next page, you can drag the files into the upload area and wait for them to reach 100%, and once that's done, you can use your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel and restart the server. Now you can join the server and run the /plugins command to confirm that they're working. Once you join, the first thing you're going to want to do is craft a fishing rod and then find a nearby water source. And if you have it available, I would also recommend trying to make the best rod possible by using things like enchantments to boost your experience. As for catching the fish, simply hold your fishing rod and right-click towards the water block. Wait for particle animations to appear and then pull the hook underwater, and then you can right-click to reel it in. After doing this, you're going to see a chat message appear with the type of fish that you caught. It'll also display the size and the rarity of them, including any unique items. Do this process for as long as you want, but keep in mind that the fishing rods will break after too many uses, so make sure you're stocked up, or you can use the mending enchantment to continuously repair the item. If you're wanting lots of loot, then AFK fishing might be the best option for you so that you don't have to sit around and wait. We do have a guide on that will be linked down below. As for the types of fish that you might come across, you're going to have four main categories: common, rare, epic, and legendary. As this category suggests, common fish tend to be boring or plain. Tadpoles are popular among these kinds of catches, but you might also come across tuna, rockfish, black carp, lemon sharks, and more. They measure 1 to 30 centimeters, making them the smallest to collect. One tier above common leads you to rare fish and more unique items. This is a bit more interesting than the previous type, and you might get penguin feathers, jellyfish, coral, squid ink, frogs, and more. Rare catches can be between 20 and 150 centimeters. With epic, you can come across many fascinating creatures like whales, dolphins, axolotls, turtles, and more. These can be extremely satisfying because they only appear every so often. Each one of these can vary between 125 and 800 centimeters, and some have unique lore behind them, so hover over your catch to learn more. The final tier of fish and items to collect is legendary, with a ridiculous range of 800 to 4,000 centimeters each time you catch one. They can come in many different forms, like starfish or even SpongeBob. Don't expect to find too many of these though, because they are unbelievably scarce, and some players might not even find any at all. Besides enchantments to help you get more fish, using bait is the next best tool to use. These can be found when fishing, with some ranging across different rarities. Shrimp is the most common to find, but there are others like stringy worms or a legendary lure. Depending on the type of bait you catch, it'll determine the amount of fish that it applies on. Additionally, some of these only attract specific rarities and will only work on them. These bait items can be stacked together on a certain fishing rod too. Once you've caught an entire inventory full of fish and other items, you can sell all of them in the shop, or you can pick and choose which ones to keep. After selling some, you'll notice the prices are different for each fish. This is due to their size and their rarity, meaning the bigger and the rarer, the more expensive. As for accessing this GUI, you're going to need the EMF shop command, which isn't going to be available to all players by default, but we will go over some permissions later. Another fun aspect to EvenMoreFish is contests, which are automatic or manual competitions for any participant. Server operators or players with certain access can use this command to forcibly begin an event. Just replace seconds with the amount of time you want, and then enter a specific version of the contest in the type placeholder, which can be either largest fished, most fish, specific rarity, and largest total. The names are pretty straightforward, but if you need any more info, you can check out the contest wiki page that will be linked down below. You can also configure these competitions in the settings to be automatic so that they run in certain times in-game. If you're wanting to allow players to sell their fish, their items, or access other abilities, then you're going to have to give them permissions. These are managed by plugins like Luck Perms, which create ranks or groups that have a specific command associated with each one. Here is a full list of abilities as well as permissions they're going to need. As for the plugin's configuration, these include types of bait, fish, rarities, and competitions that are available in-game. This means you can tweak their chances of being caught, the prizes for competitions, and a lot more. These are split into different files with straightforward names such as rarities, fish, competitions, etc. I recommend looking through the wiki page to learn more about the settings, the placeholders, and the other configurations. Stop your server and then head to the FTP file access from the main panel, and then log in and find the plugins directory, and then press the EvenMoreFish folder. Find your desired file to tweak, such as config YML, and then press edit to the right-hand side. Make any changes, and then when you're done, click save at the top, and then return to the main panel and restart the server to apply any of those changes. If EvenMoreFish isn't loading or it's not enabled, then double check that you've installed its dependencies, Vault and Placeholder API. After you've done that, check that you're using the correct version and then restart the server to try again. If you can't catch custom fish, then first make sure the Placeholder API is installed, and then make sure to disable the requires fishing permission setting in the config YML file and restart the server. If you want to keep this setting enabled, then you're going to have to use the EMF use rod permission to the player or rank through your group managing plugin. Even if you only add this plugin as a way to find custom items or just sell the fish that you do catch, it's a great addition to every server, and it gives players more of a reason to spend some more time fishing. That's all for this one. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.